Pixie, I'm afraid you're going to have a little bit of housekeeping to do. We messed up your cell looking for Margot's dope.
Did you find anything?
Oh, just a bit. We don't know where the main stuff is, though.
Look, I could find it. Even if she carries it on her, what does it look like?
No, Pixie, you stay right out of it.
That's right. Leave it to the big girls. Oh, I'm beat.
It's all that work you're doing for Margot. What's it like being her flunky?
I'm not her flunky. We're partners.
Oh, yeah. Maybe we could be partners. You know where she keeps the dough.
I'd rather team up with a death adder.
Do you know where she's got the coat?
Of course I do. We're partners, aren't we?
Where?
Tell you. Come on. Where do you think I keep me brains in me bum?
Maybe. It's enough like your face.
I'll have that. You know, you should invest in some of this stuff. I think you'd like it.
I'd rather not.
Oh, well, I've got plenty of customers. I don't need to heavy you.
You wouldn't dare.
What are you talking about? Oh, sure. Bloody Judy. Is your dyke girlfriend looking after you?
Judy's my friend. She's not my girlfriend.
Wait till she's been through you a couple of times. You won't be so prissy or pure.
I'm not prissy and I've never pretended to be pure. I've never pretended to be anything that I'm not.
Come on. I can see straight through that little girl lost act. I can see the way Judy laps it up too.
You're wrong.
Suit yourself, Snow White.
Look, don't call me that. I've never set myself up to be anything special. But I'm certainly better than you with your bullying and your dope peddling. I hate sharing with you. I wish they'd come and pack all of your drugs up and send you back to Barnhurst with them.
Would you keep your voice down?
Why? Everybody knows you're selling drugs. The whole prison does.
Shut up! The bloody screws don't. I don't want another word out of you. I'm going to be top dog of this crap heap. Screw Judy and Myra. The women will stick with me because I can supply what they want. And no one's going to get in my way.
Got any more stuff?
Sure, you got any money?
Oh, no, not right now, but I might be getting a visitor later. Hey, save us a couple of wines, will ya?
What's it here to?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Good. Oh, God, I'm really asleep working at this pace.
Well, Myra said we go slow, so we go slow. It's gonna wear the screws down a lot quicker than it's gonna wear us down.
You want a bet?
I don't know what you're complaining for, Margot. You've always worked at this pace.
Have a word with you, love.
So now you're going sharing with Margot.
Oh, she's awful. She was wrapping her drug deals into little packages last night.
Did you see where she was getting them from?
She got them out of her pockets, but I'm sure I can find them. She sleeps heavily. I almost got up and had a look around.
Pixie, for God's sake, you mustn't do that. Margot's a very dangerous person. Now I mean it.
Oh, but I can help. What are you going to do about it?
Nothing.
What?
Well, not at the moment. Right now, my main concern is Myra and Gloria being put in together.
Oh, but you said Myra promised to behave herself.
She did. But she also hates Gloria's guts. All Gloria has to do is say one little thing that's not right. Myra could go with a cleaver.
Hey, Pixie, you want to do a pickup? You're so good at it.
And what the hell does that mean?
Kick it around.
I'll kick you around, mate, if you don't give me a straight answer.
But straight, you can't use it. Isn't that right, Pixie?
Why are you saying all of these things? They're just not true.
Settle down. I don't care if you're a liar.
And I don't care if I lay you.
Ow!
Hey! Now you go and do your own dirty work and mind your own bloody business.
Well, well. You will have to learn to control that temper of yours, Gaffney.
I never done this.
Really? Who did then?
Beats me.
Oh. Must have been someone with a grudge against you. Or perhaps it was just someone wanting to steal something. That is, of course, a theory, isn't it?
I've got nothing worth stealing, Miss Ferguson.
Well, I'd say the person who did this doesn't believe you. And you know what, Gaffney? I think they'll try again.
But that'd be a waste of time, Miss Ferguson. Like I said, I've got nothing
worth
stealing.
You know, Gaffney, there is one truth in Wentworth. And that is you can't keep your little treasures hidden forever. It's only a matter of time. I get this mess cleaned up before I put you on a charge.
Right, Miss Ferguson.
Cheers to a night off. And your release from isolation.
Shouldn't you be slaving over a hot stove?
No. Casserole.
Come on, Jude, how about a song? I heard that you do Louis Armstrong real good. Or what about Kenny Rogers?
Oh, no, the Deltones.
Oh, yeah, we'll take a vote. Hey, Margo, what do you want, Kenny Rogers or the Deltones?
Oh. I want the bitch you turn my cell over.
Don't you start throwing your muscle around here, Gaffney. You might bite off more than you can chew.
Desmond may be in the pound, but I know she ordered it.
Well, before you start pointing your finger around in here, why don't you look to your own mates? I bet they'd do anything to get their hands on that dope.
Yeah, what about Reb or Weasel?
As a matter of fact, you might as well just give it to them. Because when Myra gets out of the pound, you are going to be out of business.
Don't count on it. The women want a top dog who'll give them what they want. Then you'll be the one sweating bright.
Good morning, Mrs. Morris.
Morning, Pixie.
Oh, come on, girls. Don't
Oh, did you see that?
Oh, fair go. Pixie haven't got the eyes open yet.
They're getting on really well now. Last night must have been awfully romantic.
Oh, yeah.
Did you and Mr. Manning have a nice time last night? I mean, a nice dinner?
Yes, thank you.
Mr. Manning told me he was invited. He's a lovely man, isn't he?
Oh, very nice fellow, Mrs. Morris. I think he's a good catch for the right girl, that is.
Oh, yes, you'd have to be the right girl. Well, somebody who understood how hard his job was and could share it with him. Well, don't you think so, Mrs. Morris?
I think if you don't hurry, you could end up with cold showers. And I'm not sure that wouldn't be a bad thing.
Oh, I knew there was something I forgot. Do you mind if I go and get my shower back?
Oh, Pixie, please make it snappy.
You still dealing?
Maybe.
What do you mean, maybe?
But the cash, you got any stuff, haven't you?
Sure you didn't try and help yourself last night?
Of course not. Told you, I'm on your side.
Yeah, like a rash.
Say, Pixie, I told you to hurry up.
I'm going as fast as I can. Honestly, I am.
Right, I'll go and get the others.
Oh,
put a sock in it, Parker, as if it isn't bad enough. You know, your trouble, Keith. You're so busy having a bad time, you wouldn't know a good time to hit between the eyeballs. How you going, Pix?
Oh, really well, thanks, sir. Only, I couldn't find my things. Oh, I'm sorry I dropped your talcum powder, Margo, but I didn't spill very much.
You what?
Oh, don't worry about it, because I picked most of it up. But really, if it smells as bad as that, you should be thankful. Your soap smells absolutely beautiful.
You've been at my things, you bitch!
But I didn't steal anything. I'll pay you back a fire. Honestly,
you don't touch another person's things. Or have the rules changed since I was last here?
The rules haven't changed. You just forgot, that's all.
It's only a lousy cake of soap.
That's not the point, is it?
I didn't mean to do anything wrong, Judy.
Yeah, I know that, love, but please, don't let it happen again, okay?
I don't know why everybody's so upset. The water's so nice today, isn't it?
Yeah, sing along, Pix. Mams, in bib, look,
mams. Choice and enduring, bib, look, store, bib, look,
bib. Now, the Tim Dunny fell on a brick by
a brick.
Tell us where you're mates.
Oh, of course you are, but I'm having a wonderful time. What's wrong with that?
Pixie, have you been into Margot's stuff?
Oh, Judy, I wouldn't do anything like that. Oh, heavens, what is wrong with everybody today? Looks like I have to cheer you all up.
She should be coming out of it by now. Gee, she was lucky.
Yeah, more ways than one. I'd love to know who got her fired up like that.
Could be Margot. She was real mad at Pix this morning. Could be her way of getting back.
I don't think so. I don't think Margo would ever give away something for nothing. She might give Pixie a black eye, but she'd never give her any free dope. Mm. Listen, Myra. Margo's going to try and make a bid for top dog.
Oh, Jude, you think I give a damn about that now?
Well, you have to. Now, if you don't, this place is going to be run with dope. The women don't want that. They're counting on you. You've got to give a damn.